let me open with these words. We've come together in the presence of God to celebrate the marriage of Gary and Maria, to ask His blessing on them, and to share in their joy. Our Lord Jesus Christ was Himself a guest at the wedding of Cana in Galilee. And through His Spirit, He is with us now. The Bible tells us that marriage is a gift of God in creation and a means of His grace, a holy mystery in which man and woman become one flesh. It is God's purpose that as husband and wife give themselves to each other in love throughout their lives, they should be united in that love as Christ is united with His church. Marriage is given to husband and wife comfort and help each other, living faithfully together in need and in plenty, in sorrow and in joy. It's given that in delight and tenderness they know each other in love, and through the joy of their union may strengthen the union of their hearts and lives. It's given as a foundation for family life, which children may be born and nurtured in according to God's will. In marriage, husband and wife belong to one another, and they begin a new life together in the community. It's a way of life that all should honour, and it wasn't undertaken carelessly, it wasn't undertaken lightly or selfishly, but reverently, responsibly, after serious thought. This is the way of life created and hallowed by God that Gary and Maria began 35 years ago, and we celebrate this today. We remember they gave consent to each other, and today they will join hands. They'll exchange the solemn vows once again, and in token of this, they're going to exchange rings. Therefore, on this, the day when they renew those vows and we celebrate that wedding, we pray with them that, strengthened and guided by God, they will fulfill His purpose for the whole of their earthly life together. And to celebrate, we're going to sing our first hymn. And on the tables just in front of you, you'll find one of these blue books.
There was only you and me. We were young and wild and free. Now nothing can take you away from me. We've been down that road before, but that's over now. You may come in back for more. Baby, you're all that I want, and you're lying here in my arms. I'm finding it hard to believe we're in heaven. Love is all that I need, and I found it there in your heart. It isn't too hard to see we're in heaven. Pick you up when you're feeling down.
share our special moment. As you know, it's 35 years on Saturday. Happy Monday. What's that? We stood at this altar and made vows I'd always be true, and I find that my love is stronger than the day that I spend with you. You've been my best friend for a lifetime, my partner, my lover, my wife, and believe me, I know how lucky I am every day that I share your life. So today is a day to remember with all our family and friends, and therefore I give you this promise: I will love you until the end.
The toothpaste had a lid on, he always shuts the door. She's very clean and tidy, though sometimes may delude. Leave your things out at your peril, in a second they'll be moved. He romances her and dines her, uncooked dinners and the like. He even knows her favourite food and spoils her day and night. She's thoughtful when he looks at her, a smile upon his face. Will he look as good in 50 years when his false teeth aren't in place? He says he loves her figure and her mental prowess too. But when gravity takes over, will she charm with her IQ? She says she loves his kindness and his patience is a must. And of course she thinks he's handsome, which in her eyes is a plus. They're both not only perfect, but who are we to judge? He can be pig-headed, as she won't even budge. He's been more than her husband, he's also been a friend. And she's been more than just his wife, she's his soulmate till the end.
Oh, bizarre.